Welcome to the project. Here we are doing the heat transfer enhancement in the spiral plate heat exchanger using nanofluids. Abstract. Heat exchanger is a device which produces a flow of thermal energy between two or more fluids at different temperature. As heat exchangers are used in many applications, the efficient heat exchangers have tremendous demand from industries. The main purpose of this study is to analyze the performance of spiral plate and spiral coil heat exchanger using nanofluids. Go back to the introduction. Heat exchanger between flowing fluids is one of the most important physical processes, and a variety of heat exchangers are used in different industrial applications, as in process industries, compact exchangers, nuclear power plants, refrigeration power plants, chemical processing and food industries, and etc. The main purpose of constructing a heat exchanger is to get an efficient method of heat transfer from one fluid to another by direct contact or by indirect contact. The heat transfer occurs by three modes: conduction, convection and radiation. Conduction takes place when the heat from high temperature fluid flows through the surrounding solid wall. The conductive heat transfer can be enhanced by selecting a minimum thickness of wall of highly conductive material. But convection plays a major role in the performance of heat exchanger. Helical coil configuration is very effective for heat exchanger because they can accommodate a large heat transfer area in very small space with very high heat transfer coefficients. The flow through a curved pipe has been attracting much attention of researchers. The objective of the project. In the current study, we are using different nanoparticles in cold side of fluid in the heat exchange and make an attempt to calculate the performance of heat exchange using Nusselt number, Reynolds number and calculating the heat transfer coefficient and effectiveness of heat exchanger and plotting them against the Reynolds number. Heat exchanger. Heat exchanger is a device which produces a flow of thermal energy between two or more fluids at different temperature. Here we use spiral heat exchanger. Spiral plate heat exchanger. A spiral heat exchanger is composed of two long flat plates wrapped around a mandrel or center tube, creating two concentric spiral channels. The hot fluid flows into center of the unit and spiral outward toward the outer plate, while at the same time the cold fluid enter the periphery and spiral inward, exciting at the center. The space between the two plates is kept by welded bolts. Nanoparticles. A nanoparticle is defined as a small object that behaves as a whole unit with respect to its transport and properties. Nanoparticles are particles between 1 and 100 nanometer in size with a surrounding interfacial layer. Here we are using the titanium oxide as the nanofluid, which has between the range of 1 and 35% in mass is present. These are the nanofluids. In fact, they are supposed to present high thermal conductivity, which for a reason in paper, a water-based nanofluid contains titanium oxide, wherein concentration had been considered. Long mean temperature difference. Heat flow between hot and cold stream due to temperature difference existing between two sides from the heat exchanger equation can be shown the integration average temperature difference. Reynolds number. Reynolds number is an important dimensional point in fluid mechanics used to help predict flow patterns in different fluid flow situations. Nusselt number. In fluid dynamics, the Nusselt number is the ratio of convective to conductive heat transfer at a boundary in a fluid. This is the design of our spiral plate heat exchanger. Relationship between length and number of coils. This is the set exam relation between those. This is the cut sectional view of our flow through pipe in which the hot fluid and the cold fluid passes through in the opposite directions. This is the fabrication of spiral plate heat exchanger. A spiral heat exchanger is composed of two long flat plates wrapped around the mandrel or center tube, creating two concentric spiral channels. Typically, spiral heat exchanger are available in three configurations: media in full current flow, combination spiral flow and cross flow. One medium in spiral flow wrist, the other in recent cross flow. This is the data reductions, some of the data for our calculations. These are some of the codings. And the experimental procedure is set up and evaluated in thermal lab in Veltech University and tested. Mild steel is used in fabricating the spiral plate heat exchanger. With the thickness of plate is 1 mm, gap of 0.015 meter is allowed between the plates and a height of 0.225 meters. First, we need to set the rate of flow of hot fluid at 1000 lph. Now switch on the cold pump and set the flow rate at 250 lph and is recorded that the cold temperature is 30°C. Heat the water till it reaches the 50°C and start the hot side pump. Now the outlet temperature of both cold and hot fluid. Now set the flow rate of cold fluid to 500 lph. Repeat step 3 and 4. Similarly, note down the reading for 750 lph and 1000 lph. And successfully, we note down the THI, THO, TCI, TCO for pure water at 30°C on cold side and pure water at 50°, 60° and 70°C on hot side of the spiral plate heat exchanger. Now add 10% by weight of titanium oxide nanoparticles to the cold fluid. Repeat the above procedure and note down the readings. By this, the experiment using 25% by weight and 50% by weight of titanium oxide nanoparticles in water and note down the values. Here is the output. The efficiency of the is plotted in the graphs. Graph plotted between the Reynolds number and effectiveness of heat exchanger with 10% by weight of nanoparticles in water. In each plot, there will be a slight difference of increase in the performance. As per the result of the experimental results are in the form of graphs, Reynolds number and the effectiveness. The spiral plate exchanger for concentration 0% 0.1% 0.25% and 0.50% by volume of nanofluids repeatedly respectively in water on the cold side of the spiral plate heat exchanger. It is clear that the pumping power intensive array with increase in Reynolds number and increase in concentration of nanofluids, but with the rise of temperature there is a slight decrease in consumption of the viscosity of the fluid decreases. Conclusion of the experiment. In this study, experiment was successfully performed on a spiral plate heat exchanger with hot and cold fluids. The conclusion drawn by the varying mass flow rates of cold fluid are as follows. It is clear that the effectiveness of spiral heat exchanger increases with the increase in Reynolds number. For the same Reynolds number, the effectiveness can be increased by increasing the temperature of the hot fluid. Also, it is clear that the pumping power intensity either with increase in Reynolds number or increase in concentration. The nanoparticles can be employed in enhancing the heat transfer rate of the heat exchanger. The pumping power intensified by increasing either concentration or Reynolds number and the effect of concentration on the pumping power becomes more noticeable. Thank you.